Greenville, South Carolina, as I was, and we were both members. Our families were in Christ Church, and our mothers were very active in Sunday school, Christian education, so forth at Christ Church. So, and then your father had bought purchased a small farm
right.
just off the Canoga property that had a small house on it. And one summer, Christ Church sent our two mothers up here to attend what I think they called adult conference at the time.
He came up here for the first time with St. John's Episcopal there in Charlotte. And Bob Hayden was rector, and this was Bob's favorite place in that he grew up around here. And it was in October, and it was so cold in that cabin. We got up in the morning, and but we had a wonderful time. And we used to come up here often, and Bob would call square dancing, and oh, it was just a great time.
And if you're not a golfer, or even if you are a golfer, one of the best ways in the world to get to know someone is to go play golf with them. Because you're going to learn about all their frustrations as well as all their great happiness. And that's where I got to know Bobby Hayden. He just left an impression with me that was so good. And it wasn't until another day or so later that I learned he was a retired priest. I didn't know that while we were playing golf. I might have watched my words a little more carefully at that point.
Yeah, Bob often says in some of his lectures how amazing it is that Marianne stayed with him all these years. Because he was inclined to do, he used that example in his lectures on the Myers-Briggs typology instrument that was developed from analytical psychology. And he talked about their differences in their personality, and he would say that he would often do unexpected things that annoyed Marianne. And Marianne would indicate, you know, Bob, I just don't think I can take this anymore. And Bob would say to Marianne, you know, if you left me, you'd just get bored. So they're a wonderful and amazing couple, and she really does bring such insight and strength that has helped Bob do what he's been able to do.
We were so blessed that when we were a very young couple that we were able to buy our mountain home as a second home. And so many people that do this, their children love it when they're little, but then when they're teenagers, they don't want to come. But we never had that problem because somehow the Canoga area was just a fun area for our children. Sometimes we had to wait until, like Jimmy, he was such an outstanding baseball player, all-star, and we had to pretend we were so sad when his team lost and we were finally able to come up to the mountain house for the summer.
Bob had a series of Sunday school adult forum, what we called it, the adult forum. And we picked topics. There was an attorney there that I worked with. And we picked topics that we felt that informed Christians really should know about. And this was after Reagan. But we had a program having to do with what was happening in Russia at the time. And there was a lot of foment going on. And we had three professors from the local university, the Charlotte University of UNC Charlotte, and one was a professor, a short little guy that was from one of the East Zone countries. His name was Professor Jim Gotch, and he started talking and he said, well, there's a fellow called Gorbachev. We don't know much about him, but if he ever makes it to the top, this whole thing is going to come apart. And there you heard it from Bob Hayden's Sunday school class.
The story that I heard about how this labyrinth came to be is, it might not be true, but I heard that that Albert Gooch was interested in getting a conference, particularly at the beginning of the summer. He had some open space where I think around the time of year of Memorial Day, where he, before the season really started, and he was talking with Bob and said, why don't you, you know, you're thinking about this, starting this summer conference, this annual conference, why don't you do it then? Because I need somebody in at that point in time. And Bob said, well, my community really needs a labyrinth. So maybe we can make a deal here. I'll bring the conference here when you want it, but you build us a labyrinth. So Bob was always making deals. He's very good at making deals. And so that's the story I heard anyway, that he and Gooch got together and figured out how to come up with a mutually beneficial plan.
Finally, I said, I'll do the conference. If you let us build a lab.
Yeah, Bob had a way of, he had big wide arms to bring everybody in. And he did a good job of that.
You know, I think the thing about Bob Hayden that I remember the most was his sense of humor. I mean, you could be in the darkest of places, but talking to him, and he was going to light up and therefore light you up. He was this incredible scholar on the one hand, right? But at the same time, he was able to see through so many of the things that pull us down to the promise of light on the other side. And that's what I remember most about Bob when I met him over 20 years ago here. And then I would also say, as president, you know, Bob is responsible for probably more programmatic content at Canoga than any other individual in the history of this institution. Whether through the Hayden Institute or the Spirituality Conference that he helped co-sponsor, to really the people he affected and how the effect he had on those people engendered deeper programming for us. So we will miss him, but his legacy lives on.
This is some of the best experiences you'll have in your life. And the people that you meet here are going to be your friends the rest of your life. It's going to happen.